Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to bind observable data objects along with async pipes in the Syncfusion Angular TreeGrid. In this video, I will show you how to use an async pipe, subscribe to an observable object, and get the latest emitted values in the Angular TreeGrid. I assume that you are all familiar with the observables feature. In this example, I am going to use the Angular in-memory web API so that I can simulate a server and return mock data using HTTP requests and get the TreeGrid data from a local in-memory data store. So instead of going to a real backend remote server, I will get the TreeGrid data from a local data store. In this sample, I'm going to use the same code that was used in the TreeGrid customize edit dialog using templates video. In this sample, I have already configured all the necessary TreeGrid modules along with toolbar service to show the CRUD UI in the TreeGrid toolbar and edit service to enable editing in the TreeGrid. I have used toolbar service and edit service in this sample so that we have a better start point in the next video where I will cover how to perform CRUD operations using observables. So I am removing other codes that is outside the scope of this sample. Removing the code related to data binding. In the HTML template, removing other code except the TreeGrid tag and deleting the data source file. You can download this sample from the link provided in this video's description with the label Try Sample. You can also watch my TreeGrid editing video which I shared on the YouTube card. So, to work with this Angular in-memory web API, first I need to install it using the command npm install Angular in-memory web API. This command will install the Angular in-memory web API and add it to the dependency list of your application, which you can see in the package.json file over here. Create a class named TaskModel using the command ng gclass TaskModel. I have defined the needed fields in the TaskModel class. The in-memory web API library currently assumes that every data collection has a primary key called ID. Hence, I am using the same ID field name to act as the primary key for this task model. Next, I will create a service file with a command ng gservice task data. This will create a service file. So, in the task data service class, I need to implement the in-memory DB service, which will serve as a service. So to implement in-memory DB service here, first I need to import the in-memory DB service from the Angular in-memory web API package. Import from the Angular web API within the appModule.ts file and register it within the imports array of the ng-module section. Also, you can look at the code here and see I need to configure the forRoute method which accepts the class name that implements this in-memory DB service. I am passing the class TaskDataService into the forRoute method of the in-memory web API module. This can be used for redirecting both Angular HTTP and HTTP client calls to the in-memory data store and creating an in-memory database as well. Now I am going to override the createDB method with the collection of task related CRUD data. I will add a variable named tasks with the type of task model array. This tasks name is very important since I will use it as the API URL api/tasks to access the service data and add task details to the array. Also, I made it return that array at the end of this method. So, to create a task model array, I need to import it from the task model class file. Now the data is ready to retrieve from the local in-memory data store. To do this, I need to create the actual service class. I am going to create a service named task store with the command ng gservice task store. Open the task store service. Now I need to make a class that extends the subject with which we can both emit the values as well as register the subscribers. So to extend from the subject class, I need to import it from the rx.js package. And you can see the type enclosed as data state change event args. I will explain later why we are using this data state change event args here. To define this type, I need to import it from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular TreeGrid package. Now, within this service, I am going to define the URL to point to the remote API through which I am going to access the service data. API URL equal to API/tasks. Remember, I mentioned that earlier. Next, I need to inject the HTTP client service here within the constructor to enable data communication. So in the appmodule.ts file, import the HTTP client module from Angular common HTTP and add it to the imports array. In the task store service file, define the super method here to access the parent. I will define the getTasks method, which returns task model array observable to retrieve the data through the remote call. I need to import observable from the rx.js package. Here, I use the map operation within this getTasks method, so I had to import it from the rx.js operations path. So looking into this getTasks method, to read all the data, I am going to use the http.get method inside the service. With the help of the observables returned from the created task model array and the remote call. Also, I have used the pipe and map operators to read the emitted data and return it in an object format, mentioning the result and count specifically. This is due to the Angular TreeGrid source process the remote data binding based on this result and count format. Hence, I have defined the type data state change event args at the beginning of this service class creation. It is an interface that comprises a specific property collections like result, count, and so on. I have completed the implementation of the getTasks method. Now I will subscribe to the returned observable using a method. Here I have defined a method execute where I have called the subscribe method to the observables returned by the method getTasks. Next, let me define an observable variable to access the service instance. To do so, in the appcomponent.ts file, I will initialize the observable variable named tasks with the type observable data state change event args. I will access the service instance using this tasks observable variable. I will import observable from the rx.js library and import the data state change event args from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular TreeGrid package. I am defining the constructor and receiving the task store service here with a parameter named task service and assign the observable member variable tasks with the received task service object. In the ng-onInit method, I will make a call to the execute method which holds the subscribe code. You can notice here that I have passed an object that includes the values to skip and to take. The skip indicates the first n records that are to be skipped and take indicates the next n record count after the skip value to take from the data store. So I am passing this as a parameter to this execute method so that the records are retrieved from the observables based on this passed state value. I will assign this task variable to the data source property of the Angular TreeGrid. Also, I am passing the async pipe over here. This async pipe subscribes to an observable and returns the latest value it has emitted. Whenever a new value is emitted from observables, this async pipe signals the component to check for the changes. I am adding 5 columns using the columns directive. I have assigned a field attribute for all columns as per the underlying data source field names. Here, I have marked ID field as a primary key. Remember, I have mentioned the reason earlier. Also, I have added type and edit type attributes for all columns. I am setting the hashChild mapping property as isParent since the data is self-referential and so it can establish the parent-child relationship. I am setting the parent ID mapping as parent ID, ID mapping as ID since ID is the primary key. I am setting the edit settings and toolbar properties with their created objects respectively. We are all set now. Let me run the application with the command ng serve open. Now you can see the TreeGrid populated with the data from the observable object. Now I will click the collapse button of the first parent node to collapse it and then click again to expand it. But you will see I cannot expand it. This is because while binding the TreeGrid with observables, the data will be loaded dynamically. So we need to manually refresh the TreeGrid to get the child records while doing operations like expanding. To achieve this, I need to use the data state change event, which will be triggered when any TreeGrid actions like expand, collapse, page, and sort are performed. So I am declaring the data state change event and assigning the method name data state change to it. In the appComponent.ts file, I am implementing the method data state change with an argument type data state change event args that contains the state information. Within this function, call the task service class execute method by passing the state object as parameter to load the data again. To load child records, when clicking an expand button in the TreeGrid, I am handling this in the execute method by checking the condition. If the request type is expand, call the state's child data bind method. This will load the child for the expanded node. Save the file. Now you can perform collapse and expand operations. The child rows are loaded properly. Let me summarize the points we have seen in this video. We have seen how to set up a mock data server using the Angular in-memory web API, subscribe to an observable object and get the latest emitted values in the Angular TreeGrid. Also, I have explained how to bind observable data while the expand operation is performed in the TreeGrid. You can download this featured sample from the link provided in the description below with the label complete sample. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications for our newest videos. Thanks for watching.